This is Da Vinci's Mona Lisa. This is the original. Remember, mine looked like this. And hopefully you guys followed along and did that too. And it's interesting to see what you remember and what you don't remember and why you remember it and why you don't. And there's different reasons why I remembered what I did. I remembered that she didn't really have eyebrows and eyelashes, and her hands were folded a very particular way, and I was very proud of my hands and made them fold in a certain way. And why is that? Well, that was a pose. It's a very recognizable pose, especially for royalty or queens, the Virgin Mary, anything showing that it's virtuous. So this is supposed to show that the sitter was a good mom, good wife, and like a wedding pose without the wedding dress, the wedding flowers, and a ring. No, she's not wearing a ring. And the fact that she had or doesn't have eyebrows and eyelashes, I tried to really capture that in mind. That was something I definitely remembered. And that was the style back in the day. A lot of women were known for removing their facial hair, including eyebrows and eyelashes. But it's also thought that Da Vinci did actually paint those in, but because of the aging and the wear and the tear, his varnish aged, and as we all know, Da Vinci experimented with his oil paint and invented lots of different things. And that's why you have some cracking. If I zoom in on this, you can start to really see some of that cracking. So it's thought that they were on there, you know, that it was painted in, but that has disappeared over time. And it's also back to that whole idea of the cracking and the wear and tear. It hasn't really been retouched that much. So it's like, well, what did the Mona Lisa actually look like? So we can go to look at images like this. This is something probably the Mona Lisa looked like. The same kind of bright colors and lighter blues and brighter reds. And this is how that painting looked before it was retouched. So you get this really dark black background and black shadowing, and this is actually what it would have looked like when it was painted. I bring up this painting because this is was painted at the same time as the Mona Lisa. It was in Leonardo's workshop, and a student of his that painted the Mona Lisa along with his Mona Lisa painting. And if you look at the two, it's said that they have the same look and that they're just from a slightly different view. So it's not the same, sorry, this is super touchy. It's not the same picture and it's slightly different. Like the view is slightly different. So, you know, Da Vinci would have been on one side and then Sally would have been on the other side, and they were painting them together and they're dated to the same time. So what's really interesting about that, I wish I could zoom in and it wasn't so crazy, is that this is, the scholars feel like, one of the first examples of 3D painting. Let's see, it is called, what is it called? Stereoscopic depth. So what that means, and I'm sure you've done those like 3D optical illusion things where you look at it and then you kind of cross your eyes and they become 3D, right? Well, that's what this is. So they're saying that this is possibly a Da Vinci invention where your eye is supposed to create, if you were to stare at the two images at once, that if by crossing the images with your eyes in that 3D illusion, that you would get a 3D painting of the Mona Lisa. And this, if you layered those two paintings together on top of one another, this is what you get. Oh, wait, hold on. Oh, that's my dog. This. So it's actually very, very cool. And so that you see this like kind of layered 3D, and it looks 3D when you look at that. So very believable. So those are those three images, the two and then the end of the third. All right, let me pull up something. But this is how the Mona Lisa is seen today. That's the museum. It's super crowded. You can't really get to it. It's behind bulletproof glass. It's got a humidity control system in there so it doesn't warp or further deterioration going on. No one can steal it. I find it very interesting that in the same room that there's beautiful paintings all over it and no one really pays attention to that. I actually have that pulled up right here where you can view. So this is across the way from the Mona Lisa. This is a feast, a wedding feast. Huge, huge painting, just beautiful. So this is the room. This is an amazing painting. I loved this one when I was there. You can see how big it is, and it's from kind of an aerial sky view. I think that's a Titan, but don't quote me on that. I don't really know. But as you can see, I'd have to look that up. This whole room, there's paintings all over it, and on the other side of the Mona Lisa too, there's a ton of paintings. But everybody, this is the main attraction, and that's where everyone floods to. Also came across this other Mona Lisa imitation by Raphael. I love Raphael. And it's not the Mona Lisa, but it's influenced. He was influenced by Da Vinci's Mona Lisa. And you have her sitting with a unicorn. Love that. Thought that was very, very cool. Hadn't ever seen that Raphael painting before and thought, why the heck not? And this is the other Mona Lisa that is debated on that this is actually the original Mona Lisa, that this painting was painted before the one that we know. And then there's people that say, no, wait, this isn't even a Da Vinci. This is nothing. And this painting is kind of speculated that possibly it was a way to boost the Leonardo da Vinci Foundation and to make a bunch of money by claiming that this is an original. It was denied that it was an original, and then it was actually reconfirmed that it is an original painting. I don't know if I believe that. it very well could be. It's got like a classic look, and it's really hard to tell with the aging process of a lot of Da Vinci's paintings. However, I just don't feel like it is. I guess you can make your own decision. And that's kind of my spiel on Mona Lisa. And I hope you found that a little bit more interesting. I could go on and on. I didn't even talk about the ideas of iconography and Neoplatonism and how the Madonna is a virgin and why this image is so popular and so famous. But we can save that for another day.